那么接下来呢，我们的一位keynote speaker 是 Nicholas Hedman。Nicholas Hedman 呢，他是 Apache 基金会 Zest 项目的 VP。那么除了他在 Apache 基金会内部的一些职务之外呢，大家都知道做开源的人其实是有很多张名片的。那么他是Code Dragons 的 CEO， 然后也是 Bali Automation 的 CEO， 然后呢他也是 Bright Things 的联合创始人。看到这么多 title， 是不是眼睛有点被亮瞎了？那么那个Nicholas Hedman 嘛，他是一位开源专家，他拥有非常高的开源水平。而且他也非常乐于的贡献社区。今天他的主题呢，是每一个开源的程序员特别想听到的，那么就是如何在 Apache 做 Apache 项目的孵化。那么现在我们掌声有请 Nicholas Hedman。
I will not embarrass myself with my Chinese。
在这里呢，我就也不会让自己难堪，我就不说中文了。
And I willhave a hard time follow up on Aaron's excellent speak, excellent slides, and very interesting subject.
Aaron 呢，刚才讲的太好了，准备的这个幻灯片又有意思，然后他讲的内容又有意思，所以呢，我作为第二个发言人，感觉还是有压力的。
There was a lot of talks yesterday, outside of these rooms about how to engage the Chinese communities to be involved in open source outside of China.
那其实昨天一天啊，我们在会外呢也有大量的这个讨论，如何让更多的一些中国的这个个人加入到呢我们的这个开源社区来。
And I will go through the process of how Apache handles new projects coming in to grow the foundation and getting a bigger and bigger and more exciting world of projects working together under the ASF umbrella. And that is called Apache Incubator.
那下面我就为大家介绍一下，作为一个全新的这个项目，你如何呢进入到我们 Apache 软件基金会的这样一些开源社区来。那我为大家介绍一下进入的过程，那我们把它称为 Apache 孵化器。
So my name is Nicholas Hedman. I'm born in Sweden. And what you see here is the first computer that I worked with as a professional. It's called an Osborne 1, andOn the left there is something called a floppy disk that you may have heard of.
那么首先呢，我叫 Nicholas， 我是出生于瑞典，所以我是个瑞典人。那大家看一下这个图片上啊，那么是这个我参与工作的这个第一台这个电脑叫 Osborne， 还有在它的这个左边叫 Zeclus， 我不知道大家应该听过这个电脑的名字吧。
And we didn't even have MS-DOS at the time. It was something called CPM. And this was the advanced version, the CPM Plus. And this was the microprocessor. It's a Zilog Z80 that was state of the art at the time.
那其实在我们那个时候谈到系统 ,MS-DOS 呢都还没有。我们用的是 CPM。给大家看显示的是 CPM 的这个高级版叫 CPM 加。然后呢，中间有一个芯片的这个图片，是 Zilog AT 的这个芯片。
As for reference, that computer took 1.5 second to boot from that floppy disk using 1 megahertz clock cycle.
Only 1.2 seconds.
1.5 seconds.
Oh, that's very fast. 那给大家介绍一下啊。那大家看这个左边呢是个软盘，这个电脑启动啊是从这个软盘启动，它的启动呢是花1.5秒钟。
And computers today takes half a minute, even though they are 5 times faster. Think about that.
而且当时我们就1兆的内存啊，可是你想想现在的这个电脑，这个它的这个内存量真的非常之大。可是呢，它却需要半分钟的时间，也就是30秒钟的时间才能启动。
And I have high hopes for China because there's a lot of brilliant people here. Can you fix that problem? So my computer.
我对中国人民的这个期望值还是非常大的，因为你们都非常的聪明，你们能不能解决一下这个问题呢
？So my computer starts in 1 second.
这样的话，我的电脑能够回到从前，这个1秒钟就启动。
Key dates. I started with Apache in 1998 with my first contribution, a small patch.
那我记得啊，我跟 Apache 呢首次呢有关系是在1998年，当时呢我向 Apache 递交了第一个补丁文件。
and became a committer in 2002 and member in 2007. I live in Shanghai for 4 years, so that's why I'm embarrassed about my Chinese.
那么我是 02年 成为了阿帕奇的这个叫做承诺者， 07年呢 正式成为阿帕奇的这样一个成员。 那其实我为什么说我不好意思讲中文呢？ 是因为我在上海呢 其实待过4年的时间。
And I work for an American investment bank, so I don't need to speak Chinese at work.
当时我是为这个在中国的一家美国的这个投资银行工作， 所以做这份工作呢，我也不需要说中文。
So what is the incubator?
好，我们来介绍一下什么是孵化器。
Well, it's these projects, or these, what we call potlings. These are the candidates who are under training to become projects in Apache. This is the current list, and as of Thursday, Calcite was promoted or graduated to the top level project.
大家看啊，其实呢，所谓的孵化器就像一些摇篮，在这个摇篮里有很多处于婴儿期的这样的一些项目。那你现在看到这些项目呢，就是目前在我们的这个Apache的摇篮里头孵化器里面的这样的一些婴儿。那你看这个 Calcite， 我把它涂掉了，是因为它已经长大了，就要已经从这个孵化器里离开了。
We find in this list some highly well-known projects like Groovy, which is a programming language a lot of people use, but is now under incubation to become an Apache project.
事实上啊，这里有很多大家非常知名的一些东西，比如说 Groovy，Groovy 是大家很熟的一个编程语言吧，但是现在呢，它又跑到我们这个 Apache 的这个孵化器里头。
We can also see a project called Wave, which is a Google technology for collaboration that they ran as a commercial project for a while, but didn't have the uptake they wanted, and they decided to open source it for other people to use it.
大家可能在这个名单中发现了Wave， 就是最右边下面数第二个的这个Wave。Wave 你们知道吗？是原来谷歌。谷歌呢做协同社交的这样的一个商品，实际上他们已经把它做成一个产品了。但是后来谷歌觉得，哎呀，这个东西还要更新挺麻烦的，就干脆把它开源了，所以就放到我们这样的一个孵化器里来了。And
out of the 168 projects in Apache, approximately 150 of them has gone through the incubator, and very few has had other ways of being established as projects in Apache.
那我们谈到现在Apache的项目呢，168个，其中有150个呢都经历了这样的一个孵化器的这个过程。那只有很少数的，它是通过其他的方式来加入的。But
that doesn't really tell us what the incubator really is. It only could tell us what the result or the current process going through at the moment. I want to describe what does it mean to incubate a project from one end to the finish line.
但是大家只是看到了在孵化器里头有什么，还没有谈到到底这个孵化的流程是什么样的。那我就为大家介绍一下。
And the official website explanation for this is the entry path into the Apache Software Foundation for projects and code bases wishing to become part of the foundation.
那么我们 ASF 的官方网站解释指的是孵化器，指的是如果你想作为一个软件的项目或者是一个码机，那么正式加入我们基金会的官方的这个加入通道就是孵化器。And
this policy started all the way back in 2002, first project coming through the incubator in 2003.
那事实上啊，我们这个孵化器的制度呢，是在02年呢正式的这个建立起来，然后在03呢就有很多的这个项目了。And
it consists of a couple of processes that should be followed to teach projects how to operate as Apache projects.
那么它的流程分为什么呢？其实走这几个流程的主要的目的呢，是对这些加入的项目做一个培训，告诉他们要成为一个阿帕奇的项目应该怎么做。First
of all is the so-called fast track process.
那么第一个流程呢，叫做快速通道流程。
It is when a project management committee has come in touch with typically one developer who has a piece of code that he wants to bring into the Apache as part of another project.
那通常是一个 PMC， 我们叫做项目管理委员会的这个人，他和某一位，这很典型的某一位开发人员的进行接洽，因为这个开发人员呢想把他的一些代码呢加入到基金。That
could be, for instance, an extension or a particular feature that is pluggable into an existing project.
也就是说呢，这个开发人员的贡献的这个代码有可能只是某一个功能，这个功能呢可以插入到现有的这个系统里。
So somebody from the project where that piece of code will arrive to will do an code import, and there will be a review and filling out some forms.
那么所以呢，如果你这个要添加的功能相关的那个系统项目，这个的 PMC 项目管理人员呢，会来跟你找你帮你做呢代码的这个导入建档，然后呢让你填一些表，这些表格主要是为了法务方面的这样一些事务。
And then the incubator or the members, the people of the incubator will take a review and make sure that there is nothing suspicious about the code or, and then accept or reject it. There has not been many rejections. I can't recall any. So that is a fast process and takes a couple of days. No big deal.
那然后呢，就是有相关方面的这个我们社区的这些这个项目的人员呢，会对你的这个码做一个审核。那看的这个代码里头没有什么恶意的这个东西，然后就会做出选择接受还是拒绝。那根据我的这个经验呢，拒绝的非常少，几乎没有。所以呢，整个这个快速这个通道的这个过程呢，应该很简单的。Wrong
button. But most of the time, it is not the code that is coming to the Apache Software Foundation. It is people.
但其实呢，加入我们基金的不是代码本身，而是这些开发人员。And
most people doesn't understand how Apache operates and need to be trained to do so.
其实呢，每一个新人加入进来，他们都不大清楚这个阿帕奇到底是怎么做事情的，所以呢，我们需要对他们进行培训。
And the role of the incubator is to teach these people what it means to operate according to the Apache way.
所以呢，事实上，整个的孵化的过程呢，就是我们对于这样的一些加入的新人进行阿帕奇知道的培训的过程。This
process starts with a discussion on a public mailing list.
首先呢，我们的这个培训的一开始，或者是孵化的一开始呢，都是一个叫做公众的电邮清单。And
a proposal is written.
然后呢，我们会写一个建议书。Which
goes to a vote of the incubator members.
然后呢，让所有的孵化器的成员来投票。And
then the project becomes a so-called podling.
然后呢，这个项目就成为了我们的一个婴儿项目。And
that is a long period of time. And once they are ready, they will graduate similar to students.
那我们就看这些婴儿就像学生一样成长，然后就最后毕业了。To
talk a bit more about the details around this.
那我们再来介绍一些细节。
The discussion starts on this mailing list, general incubator apache.org.
那基本上呢，我们呢可以在这个电邮，就是幻灯片最下的 general@incubator.apache.org 上呢，你可以看到它的这个电邮清单。And
the proposal, the people who are coming and saying we would like to become part of Apache, they bring forward, we have this code, please help us.
一般来说呢，会有程序人员过来跟我们说：“我有这些代码，那你能不能帮我一下呢？”
And in that discussion, we identify the champions, the sponsor, the mentors for the proposal that is presented to us.
那根据这个程序员呢，他递交的这样一个代码的这个建议书，我们帮他找到一个我们所说的这个支持者，一个赞助者，再帮他找一些导师。
Very often the the Apache people have questions around the project. It could be about their community, it could be about the code, it could be many other relevant or irrelevant questions.
那然后我们这些阿帕奇的人呢，就会来问这些程序员各种各样的问题，有的是有关你对社区的想法呀，有的问题是你这个代码方面的一些问题，有很多相关的，也有一些杂七杂八的问题。And
every now and then there is projects with special needs, such as Open Office. When Open Office came to Apache, they are bringing along a user base of tens of millions of people, and they have special needs to cater to releases for such a big user base.
那然后呢，可能就是一些行政啊、项目方面的问题啦，比如说，哎，这个功能做出来之后，出现了很多的大量的这样一些用户等等的这样一些，然后我们要去做发布啊等等。The
sponsor is either a project in Apache where the project coming in is likely to end up. If there is no such sponsor, the incubator itself is the sponsor, and it's an indicator that there is support to bring this project into the foundation.
那事实上呢，我们就会找啊，你这个项目的这样的一些所谓的赞助方。所谓的这个赞助方呢，就是说你建议的这个代码这样的一些码和我们阿帕奇现在的这样的一些项目是不是有相关性？如果有相关性，直接这个项目现有的这个项目就是你的这个赞助方。It
doesn't involve any kind of money or financial transaction whatsoever.
但是我们这个赞助跟钱没有关系啊，这个赞助和钱是没有关系的。The
champion is the representative of the project to the incubator. It's typically somebody working in the incubator already, but it can be another Apache member.
那么所谓的这个项目的支持者指的是什么呢？通常呢，就是所谓的这个项目代表，可能是我们阿帕奇的这样一个成员，他来关注、来支持你这个项目。The
champion helps the incoming project to write the proposal because the champion have seen how they should be written and what is the concerns of the foundation when they are looking at new proposals.
为什么要有这样的一个角色呢？ 因为像我们阿帕奇的这样的一些成员，我们对于你的项目建议书应该怎么写啊，非常的这个清楚，也就是代码建议书啊，所以他会知道呢，可能这边会问一些什么样的问题，可以帮助你把这个建议书写得更好。The
champion is also expected to help create the first board reports. The each project, each podling have to report their activity to the incubator, which will in turn put that report to the board for these gentlemen here to have a look at, make sure everything runs smoothly.
同时呢，每一个孵化器里的项目啊，都要向项目管理委员会最终呢是提交给董事会成员所看的这个提交董事会的这个项目报告。所以呢，你要是有这么一个支持者的话 ，champion 的话呢，他就会帮你呢，告诉你怎么写这样的一个报告。那这个报告最终呢，会有董事会的这些成员来去看。One
of the most important roles in the whole incubation process is the mentor.
那其实非常重要的一个角色，在孵化器的过程中呢，就是导师。
The mentor is the teacher. The mentor is the guru, the sifu, if you like, for the project on how to do the Apache way.
也就是说呢，这个导师就像老师一样，一步一步的带着你，告诉你呢如何以阿帕奇之道来去做你的开源项目。The
mentor typically don't have any technological interest or understanding of what the project is all about. It doesn't interfere with the coding and the technological direction of the project. His interest or her interest is purely about building the community and make them understand the Apache way.
但是呢，这个导师和老师不是说教你怎么开发，给你指定项目的技术方向，他的这个辅导工作完全和技术没有关系的，完全是社区建立方面的一些传授。Once
the everything is discussed enough, a proposal is written where everything is outlined and archived for future references to go back and see how was that proposal originally stated. It's typically a rather long document they're typically very similar. And that is placed in front of the incubator to make a vote on.
那事实上呢，这个我没有专门的这个模板啊，让你写这个代码的这个建议书。代码的这个建议书呢，有的时候篇幅还是比较长的。我们写好之后呢，要把它存档。那通常这些建议书呢，还是比较类似的。
And I learned yesterday, I have been in open source for many years, but I learned yesterday what open source is all about. It's about discussion.
那其实呢，我做开源呢已经很多年了。那昨天呢，我们又体验了一遍。其实开源就是一种讨论的过程。
We write a lot of emails. Incubator is one of the most frequented lists in the foundation. It's not the most, but it's very high traffic on it.
就是说呢，我们经常会收到啊，就我们阿帕奇的这样一个公共电邮清单里头，孵化器的这个邮件量呢是相当之大的。But
eventually there will be a vote, and practically all proposals that has a sponsor and has a champion and has mentors named, and the proposal is well written, gets through. I can't recall a denial in the incubator.
那就是在孵化器里，只要呢你找到了一个非常好的支持者、赞助者、你的这个导师，然后你的这个建议书呢写得又很好，基本上呢在这个投标过程中肯定能通过的，因为整个我就想不起来有被拒绝的。Now
starts the long process of becoming a podling. A podling is like a baby project. It is part of Apache, but it's not really part of Apache. It has to follow the rules, but it's allowed to make mistakes and get corrected.
那么然后呢，在投标通过之后呢，就进入了这个婴儿项目期。婴儿项目期也是我们经常谈的叫做种子项目。所以在这个阶段，你可以犯错，你可以调整，不断的成长。And
it's about learning where do I get help? Where, how do we do releases, and how do we interact with people, how do we be respectful to each other, and all the things that Brett spoke about yesterday.
那么其实这个阶段呢，就是我们在谈到的，就是我们要学习在整个过程中，那我如果需要帮助，我应该去找谁？我在社区中，那我应该如何去发展壮大？那如果就是如何和整个的这样一个社区内部互动的这个方式？
The mentors have a very important role here. Initially, they set up all the initial resources that is required to run the project inside Apache.
那么在这个整个的过程中啊，导师是发挥着非常重要的作用的。They
will also actively point out when people make mistakes. They will they will respond to questions about how do we do this or how do we do that. Can we use this software? Do we have to follow this process?
那其实导师啊，如果看到他辅导的这个项目人出错了，他会赶快指出来说你这个做错了。那这个项目人他就会问了，那我怎么办呢？我能不能用这个软件或者那样做？导师都会非常详尽的来解答你的问题。Being
a mentor initially is a lot of work. The first few days takes up a lot of hours, but over time, your role as a mentor diminishes and you slowly withdraw and be seen less and less.
那么导师呢，在辅导一个婴儿项目的头几天，工作量是相当之大的。但是随着这个项目的成长啊，那其实导师呢能给予的帮助也越来越少。最后呢，可能导师逐渐也就慢慢的从项目中退去了。And
the mentors is the eyes of the foundation into each of these new projects to see that they function properly.
我们认为导师呢就类似于我们阿帕奇基金会的眼睛，这些眼睛呢照料着所有的这些成长中的婴儿的项目。And
once the mentors sees that the podlings are operating healthy and the community is strong and they're doing all the right things that we expect from them, they propose graduation. They present that to the incubator.
那如果导师这双眼睛呢，看到这个项目成长的非常不错了，导师就会在适当的时候呢建议说，哎，这个项目可以毕业了。
There are three major requirements for graduation.
但是毕业呢有三个条件。
And those are that the code base has no legal problems.
而且呢你这个码的这个基础呢应该是没有法律问题了。
That means that it follows the licenses and don't depend on other projects that has a license we cannot accept.
也就是说呢，所有的这个项目这些代码、啊、都是属于阿帕奇的这样的一些许可的这个方式，不依赖于其他的一些许可。
Second requirement is that the community around the project is healthy.
第二点条件呢，就是说你围绕的这个代码的这个社区必须是非常健康的。
And healthy means that they don't all work for the same company, or that.They have disputes within the group that they can't resolve.
所谓的健康的社区是什么呢？你不能说所有的这个你自己的这个社区里的人都是一家公司的，这个不可以。第二呢，就是说呢，你这个社区人应该到目前为止呢，对这个项目没有任何的争议了。
And the final requirement is that they have done a release.
那第三个要求就是说，你应该至少做过一次发布了。
A release has a legal implication for the foundation, and there's processes to go through to push out the software to the general public.
所谓的这个发布 release 呢，我们有阿帕奇有专门的这样的一个定义，就是说呢，把你的这些代码正式呢向外去发送。
And from a proposal to graduation, we are talking somewhere between 2 weeks to 4 years.
从我们所说的建议到毕业，快的2个星期就完成，长的4年才能完成。
It depends a lot on the incoming project. How did they operate? How did they conduct themselves before coming to Apache?
当然了，就是你这个项目在进入阿帕奇之前的自身的这个条件当然很重要。
And once they graduate, there is a resolution written and placed before the board.So they can ratify that we now have a new project in the foundation.
那你毕业之后呢？我们会向董事会呢递交一份决议书，由董事会去批准，正式成为呢阿帕奇的新项目。
But there is also some portlings that fail.
当然呢，有一些孵化失败。
A lot of the failures is due to inactivity. The community comes in, they.Cannot keep up the stamina, and they just fade away.
主要是因为呢，自身的这个项目的这个婴儿项目的这个社区没有了，就社区的这些人员他不活跃。
Some projects think that being in incubator is very convenient.
有的项目觉得到孵化器里头很方便啊。
This picture is a little bit blurred. Have a look here.
这张这个图片有点不清楚啊。
It's a person sleeping in an egg.
就是一个人睡在鸡蛋里。
Projects that don't have an interest in graduating get pushed to do so or to close down.
有些项目呢，就是说我就待在孵化器里，我不想离开。但是呢，我们就逼着他，你要不呢就毕业，要不你就干脆失败。
There are some projects that.End up being something different than intended.
有的这个项目啊，面目全非了。本来是个老鼠，出来一个别的东西。
There are a handful of projects that arrive at Apache, then they merge with another podling and become this other thing.
就是说我们所说的混血了，就是有的项目进来之后，和其他的这个孵化器里的项目合并成了一个项目。
But being an Apache project and getting to become a top-level project is a journey, and the incubator is the first step towards that.
那么，所以呢，你要成长成一个阿帕奇的这个顶级的项目啊，进入孵化器呢是第一步。
And like all journeys, they can be hard or they can be fun.
所以呢，就像任何我们走的路一样，有的时候呢很辛苦，但有的时候还是很有乐趣的。
It's all about People, it's all about having fun together, communicating, and be respectful.
其实呢，就和和人打交道一样的，你要尊重他人，那你要乐于呢和他人呢去这样的去工作，你要善于从中呢发掘快乐。
And we people in Apache already are just people. we are not special, we are not unreachable. Just reach out to us if you have proposals and we will help you get there.
我们阿帕奇的这些成员、这些董事们，我们也是，我没有什么特别的地方，我们不会非常的冷漠，很难相处。所以你们有任何的兴趣，有什么新的项目呢？欢迎你们跟我们来去接触一下。
And with that, I would like to thank you all for being here today. And is there any questions?
好，那我就讲到这里了。大家有没有问题
？OK。First, I would like to thank a very good presentation. Okay, I have two questions. First, introduce myself. I'm from Huawei company, big data team. So we are participating in so many Apache projects, like Apache Spark, Hadoop, HBase, and so on. So I have two questions. First question, actually, we not only participate in Apache project, we also want to create and one project go to incubate. Yeah. So just you mentioned that the champion, mentor, yeah, this is easy to understand. But just for the sponsor, could you give one example how to understand the sponsor this?
Sponsor is a very small role. It is not very important. It will sort itself out in early on. And if there is no other sponsor, the incubator will be the sponsor.
For example, I have one project, want to...
If it doesn't fit in anywhere else, the incubator will be the sponsor.
Sponsor, 我再解释一下，是指什么？比如说，你作为一个贡献者，你做的这个项目和现有的这个阿帕奇的项目呢，它有一些关联。比如说，你是这个功能能插到它那个项现有的阿帕奇的那个项目的里头。
Okay.
哎，他说我把你带进来，我给你一些支持，他是这个意思。如果找不到这样和你的这个开源项目相关的项目的话，那就阿帕奇基金来做你的 sponsor。
Okay. Okay. Got it.Second question, so in China, it is possible how to become Apache member? A difficult question?
No, it's not a difficult question. It's actually not part of the incubator. And being a member is what Brett spoke about yesterday. But we have many Chinese members already.In the foundation. It's about becoming, contributing and becoming valuable to the foundation.
Okay.
And once that is recognized, people will vote you in as members.
其实阿帕奇软件基金会的中国的这个成员已经非常多了。成为成员呢，它不是一个硬性的指标，是说你长期在阿帕奇很活跃，你有很多的这个贡献，然后呢，大家作为对你的这样一个认可呢，你就自然而然成为了阿帕奇的成员。
Okay.So I know you are living in Shanghai, so could I invite you to become our mentor for our project? Our project now, our all source code, source code put to GitHub for 6 months. So that name is Astro, A-S-T-R-O. It's related to Spark.
No problem.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions?I think we're out of time.
大家还有别的问题吗？这很好的机会哦。
Okay, thank you very much.
Nicholas, give the time. We have a special gift from Kai Yuan She. I'll give to you.
Thank you.Oh, supposed to stand there? Thank you.